What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, we have some WWE action figure news and a reveal for you guys, actually. Yesterday, we did have a lot of WWE Elite figure images released. You know, we talked about the Finn Balor we're going to be getting. We talked about the Rey Mysterio that we're going to be getting. And then we talked about the brand new WWE Elite Series 69 Ricochet and Mustafa Ali coming out. If you guys missed those videos, definitely go check them out on the channel. It's a bunch of Comic-Con news and some new upcoming WWE Elites that we're going to be getting in the next couple of months that will be revealed. But here today, we're going to talk about the reason, how in the hell did Mattel release this yellow attire when Mustafa Ali literally wore this attire last Friday at WWE Super Showdown in Saudi Arabia in 2019. Like, the turnaround time is absolutely incredible. If they only saw that attire on Friday at Super Showdown and then we got this image just a few days later, it's literally impossible, guys. The steps that Mattel has to make in order to see a figure, see an attire that they want to make, and then to pump it out in figure form, they have to know well in advance. And how did Mattel do this? Believe it or not, Mattel actually has been doing this for a little bit now, is where they contact the talent themselves. They get one-on-one contact with the WWE superstars, and then they figure out what attire they're going to be wearing so that we can get the attires and the figures faster. So that is what they did here with this Mustafa Ali. You guys can see by the pictures, Mustafa Ali literally wore this attire last Friday in Saudi Arabia for Super Showdown in the Battle Royal, and then yesterday it was revealed that the yellow attire that he wore then would be the Chase variant for Elite Series 69, and you guys know, here's the photo, the leaked image of the full set of WWE Elite Series 69. You can see there we have Rey Mysterio in the green, which we covered in yesterday's video. Remember I said what figure we'd be getting? Boom, there it is for Rey Mysterio in the green and white attire. That will also come with a sleeveless t-shirt. We also have Mustafa Ali in this set. We have Ricochet. We have Bobby Lashley. We have The Miz. And we have Tommaso Ciampa. And Tommaso Ciampa has a bigger torso. If you guys can see that, you zoom in there, it is a Randy Orton torso. He has a Randy Orton torso, not the small Daniel Bryan torso that we saw back at Access or WrestleMania 35. And another thing I wanted to mention is if you look back at the Mustafa Ali attire, they changed the deco from WrestleMania 35, WrestleMania Access. If you see on the left, guys, here on the screen, here is the updated Mustafa Ali on the left and the Elite Series 69 coming out soon. And then on the right, that is the WrestleMania Access figure that we saw. So you guys can see the deco is just a little bit different. I don't know why Mattel changed it. I'm not sure if one or two lines is correct, but if you go back to the photos of Mustafa Ali's attire at Super Showdown, you will see that he clearly has two lines, and then on his figure that was released, the images that were released yesterday, it only has one line. So I'm not sure if, you know, the red attire is supposed to have one line and the yellow attire is supposed to have two lines, but they were going to do different deco for both, or if one of these is inaccurate. I'm not sure if both are inaccurate. I don't know if they're going to go back to the two lines. I'm not sure, but clearly at Access, the red attire had two lines, and then at Super Showdown, the yellow attire had two lines, but here in the photos we only get one line. So I don't know, it's kind of confusing, but one line, two line, don't give a damn. It's a nice looking figure, and I'm going to get it regardless. And I really like the yellow attire. I think it looks fantastic, but I figured I would reveal that to you guys. Mattel actually contacts the talent early, finds out what they're going to be wearing so that they can, you know, pump these figures out. I bet they don't do it for certain superstars, you know, like people that would get a lot. I just don't see them doing it. I think one of the other times that we've seen this before is with AJ Styles, and we get a lot of AJ Styles figures, but I know this happened with that Survivor Series Walmart exclusive wave. You guys remember that with Bobby Roode, Alexa Bliss, and AJ Styles? I think it was rumored that AJ Styles was going to wear that attire at Survivor Series, so they went ahead and planned to make that figure. That's why we got the figure before he actually wore the attire at Elimination Chamber or something like that. He ended up not wearing it at Survivor Series. I don't know the exact story on that, but Mattel does. That's how they did it. That's how we got this Super Showdown 2019 attire from Mustafa Ali so quickly, is because they contact the talent early, which I think is a fantastic idea. It shows a lot of effort on Mattel's part, and I think think that them taking that extra step helps us get figures way faster. It helps us to know exactly what we're going, like, it helps us to know, you know, that they're trying, that they want to get the figures out as fast as possible. And I think that allows them to do a lot of wiggle room, especially with these chase variants, because, you know, they can take an attire that they've worn in the past, and then they can say, okay, well, since we have a second figure, we can actually do an attire that they haven't worn yet. Let's get in contact with them, find out what they're going to be wearing. And it's kind of crazy that it was this close, like the chase variant was released this close to when he actually wore it. Like, it's very close. I don't know if a turnaround time has ever been that quick, where the person wears it and then literally 4 days later the figure shots are released and it's in that attire. So I think that's absolutely crazy. But Elite Series 69 looks absolutely beautiful, guys. I freaking love it. I think it's one of the best sets that Mattel's ever done, especially when you consider how good the figures look. I mean, that Ricochet is easily a figure of the year candidate. This Mustafa Ali is also a figure of the year candidate. I think that Tommaso Ciampa is easily a figure of the year candidate. Rey Mysterio, once we get that in hand and see what the head skin looks like, closer detail. Bobby Lashley looks good. I mean, The Miz looks good. I think this is going to be the best Miz Elite. So I am very, very excited. I think it'd be a very huge understatement to say that I'm not excited for, or that I am excited would be a huge understatement. For how excited I am for Elite Series 69. I wanted to talk about the full set yesterday, but I mean, I released two different WWE action figure news, so I wanted to space it out just a little bit. So I figured, why not come on here, reveal how they actually got this figure out so early, and just talk about all the things here today, guys. I want to know down below what you think of the yellow attire of Mustafa Ali being the chase variant. What do you think of the rest of the series? Do you guys enjoy it? Are you going to pre-order? If you want to pre-order any of the figures you see in today's video, guys, go over to ringsidecollectibles.com. Use the promo code MDTOYS. You will save 10%. I think that if you're going to pre-order any wave, this would be the wave, because I think that these guys are going to be super hard to get. Ricochet, Mustafa Ali, you know, Tommaso Ciampa. It's going to be their best figure, so you definitely want to lock these down, especially the first time we're getting Ali, the first time we're getting Ricochet. We definitely want to lock these down, and it's the first Rey Mysterio Elite. That is a current Rey Mysterio, not flashback or WCW in a long time, so you definitely want to go lock that down. But thank you guys so very much for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more epic WWE action figure videos. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Thank you.